Are you dragging yourself through your day every day and you cannot wait to quit? You want to quit your corporate, you want to wake up in a good mood, you want to be your own boss, but you're stuck in a job. How can you quit? When can you quit? Why would you quit? That's what this video is all about. Because I want to create videos to help you, to inspire you, to motivate you, and to help you be able to make that transition to be your own boss and to live a life without permission. To live a life being your own boss and having the freedom to do what you want, where you want, when you want. Exactly what I am doing, what I'm helping my clients with. So by the way, if you haven't done so already, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Hit that red little notification, little bell, and don't miss any of my weekly videos. But let's dive right in. When, what, how? See, so many people are stuck in a cubicle every day doing their job and then going to these appraisal interviews and just pleasing your boss. It's like, oh, check, yes, I have a good appraisal, yes, whoa, 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 I do all of this because, oh, I love this company. No, you don't. You just do it to please your boss. You always have to do something and ask permission to your boss, but deep down, you're an entrepreneur. And you want to be your own boss. You want to have the freedom to wake up when you want, to do the things when you want, and to do what you want, and to do what you love, most of all, and to feel fulfilled and have this meaningful life. But there you are, you're stuck. And if you're like me, I was 40. I was 40 when I quit my corporate. And it's not an easy age, right? So you're thinking, yeah, it's easy to say, you know, quit your job, but when can you really quit your job if you don't have anything else lined up? Because when you're 40, you have insurances, you have bills to pay, you have a house, you have a mortgage, you have all the things that you want to, that you need to pay. You need the money for it. So that's why I never say take the leap of faith. I never ever say that. I was sick and tired of people telling me like, oh, Rachel, follow your heart and do what you love and just go for it, jump. No way. I need a plan and I want you to have a plan so that you can escape your corporate. Please don't jump. Don't just jump and then what? Like so many people thinking like, oh, you know, I will jump and things will happen for me. How many percentage do you think succeed by just following their heart and just doing it? Maybe 1%, maybe not even 1%. Please don't do that. I didn't do that. I'm not helping my clients to do that. No, I help you with making a plan. What I'm saying is that when you're 20 years old, you're living at your parents' house, you don't have to worry about mortgages and insurances and all of that, then yes, please, please, by all means, go and follow your heart and try it out. And if you fall, you can still find a job, you can still move in with your parents. It's okay, you're 20 years old. Please do go try. But if you're 40 years old, you're married, you have kids, or maybe you're single, but you have a house, you have a mortgage, you have all of that, then you have to take that responsibility. You have to take the responsibility and figure out how you can escape your job. And I will tell you what you can do in just 1 minute. But before I do that, I need you to know that it's scary. And I know it's scary. And I know there's this fear of what will happen, the fear of the unknown. I have so many videos about the fear of failure, the fear of the unknown, the fear of finances. There's all these fears that you have to face because yes, it's scary. But if you don't do anything, nothing will happen. If you want to change, but you don't take action, nothing will change. It's that simple. You want change, you gotta take action. When you take action, it's gonna be scary. Nobody said they live the life they love by playing it safe. But yes, a lot of people are 9 years old or at the end of their lives and they regret. The biggest pain in your life that you can have is the pain of regretting that you didn't try living the life that you love. For me, my one thing, the one thing that drives me day in, day out is that thought like, I don't want to grow old thinking, what if I had done it? I don't want to grow old regretting that I didn't try. I want to grow old and say, yes, I have done what I wanted to do. I have tried it. I have done it. So playing it safe will not get you anywhere. And the pain of regret is huge. Think about that. is it going to be scary to take action? Is it going to be scary to quit your job and to do what you love and to grow that business or whatever you want to do? Yes. But there's only one way through fear. It's going through it. It's making friends with your fear. It's shaking hands with your fear. It's moving towards it. And you know what? Fear, most people see fear as negative. I see fear as positive because fear will help you grow. When you face your fears, that's how you grow. Think about anything that you've done in life that was scary at first, but then you did it and you overcame that fear. That was a step into growing. You grow when you face that fear. Every time you were scared to do something and you did it, you were growing. It's a step into growth. So fear, it's part of it. Playing safe, no. Change, you can only change by taking action. The comfort zone is the enemy of change. You want to stay in your comfort bubble, nothing will happen, nothing will change. You want to step out of your comfort bubble, then you will see the changes and the results. So when is it time to jump? When is it time to quit your corporate? The time is there when you know for sure that you can, that you have a parachute. You know, I always say, like, don't jump without a parachute. When you have built that parachute, you can jump. In other words, what Gary Vee always says is, like, don't jump if you cannot swim. Don't jump in a swimming pool if you will drown. No, don't. So quit your job as soon as you learned how to swim. Make sense? You don't jump in a swimming pool when you're gonna drown. You need to prepare. So how do you do all of this? You make a plan. You make a plan. You decide what you want to do. What is that one passion project that you really want to make happen and work? Okay? And you start growing that. While, I always help my clients, while they're still in corporate, because I don't want them to take the leap of faith. While you're still working, you have to build that side project. Or you want to build a saving. So you can either work part-time and build your own business. You can build up a lot of saving and say, look, I'm going to work my ass off for the next 5 years and save. And then you'll have a buffer and you can quit and you will not have a financial pressure. You will be all right for a while and you can grow your dream, right? So work part-time, save. How about spending less? Why do you need to drive that specific BMW? Why do you need that house with 3 bedrooms? Why do you need that beautiful kitchen? Why do you need that huge TV screen? Why are you going out to a restaurant? Think about, or why do you spend all that money to, you know, beautiful brand clothes and all of that? Think about things that you're spending that actually you don't really need if you want to grow your business, if you want to have another life. Maybe it's time to start saving and spend less to those things. So start thinking about all that. I made a video about the fear of finances and I talk more about that. I'll put it in the description below. So do all those things and make sure that you have a plan before you quit. It is crucial. I cannot give just a broad plan right now because every person is different. Every person I work with is different and we create that plan and we figure out, hey, what is that one idea that you want to grow? What is that one thing that is really meaningful to you and that will give you the freedom that you want? Let's grow on that. But remember, if you're feeling miserable right now and you think, I'm too old, I don't know, I'm not sure, well, within 5 years, you will be even more miserable and you will be even older. So the time to change is right now. The time to change is right now. When I was starting YouTube last year, it's like, oh, but there's so many millions of videos on YouTube and why would you do that? But now I'm here and I have so many more subscribers and so many more videos and I'm growing and growing and growing. When I quit my corporate, I also build up. I was working day and evenings to grow, to publish books, to be on speaking gigs, to grow my website, to grow my business, all of that. And then I was able to quit because I built it up on the side. But I never ever give up. Whatever you want to do, don't give up. And it's not too late, and you're not too old. You're not old. We're young. We're 40 plus. We're young. We have a whole lifetime in front of us. But it's just so liberating to finally do what you want to do and have that freedom and not work for a boss. But please stop trying to ask for permission. You want to live a life without permission? It's time for you to take responsibility, to start taking action, to start making a plan, and to live that life without permission. Don't wait for permission for somebody to tell you, hey, this is why you know, you may do it now. You're allowed to do it now. No, you, it's your life. You take responsibility. You make a choice. You make a decision to change, and you start taking action right now. Yes, I'm bold. Yes, I'm straightforward, and I'm telling you like it is. There is no sugarcoating. I don't sugarcoat anything. You have to take action. If you want to know more, then talk to me, comment below, let me know. How can I help you? I'm here to help you. I've been there. I know it's scary, but oh my gosh, I'm so happy right now because I'm doing what I want. And I quit that boss and I quit that corporate because that made me miserable. And now I'm doing and I'm helping and I'm inspiring. And that is what makes me happy and fulfilled. And I want that for you too. Think about the consequence of not doing what you want. Think about the pain, the regret, the consequence of not taking action right now and changing your life. Think about that. And I'm going to leave you with that. Make sure you check the description below and the links to my workbook that will help you shift and take the steps towards freedom. And if you want to talk to me, I'm happy, happy, happy to help you. Remember to subscribe to my channel. And don't miss any of my weekly videos. And I'll be back next week. You can do this.